Sunday school.
Yes.
Praise God. Amen. So today there's no Erica, this year, Panel and Piki. They went to Belgium, but they'll be back this week starting. So this next Sunday they'll be here anyway. So you miss them today, but they'll be here next Sunday. Okay? Can we have Sunday school without Eric and Pussy? Yeah?
Yes.
Sister Rebecca, you are the only girl. Yeah? Is it hard for you? No. Elizabeth, yeah? No. Isabel's coming. Okay? Isabel's coming. Oh, you okay? Good. Praise God. So let us sing in the street by and by.
Thank you.
wonderful time, Lord, we are having with you in this moment, Lord. Such a privilege, Lord, to be found in this place, to hear, Lord, the word coming from yourself. We are more than privileged people to believe this wonderful message. Dear everlasting God, we come, Lord, as one person this time to commit ourselves to you. Father, come and have your mighty way, Lord. Take control of our Sunday school, Lord. Everything, Lord, we are going to do here, Lord, we commit it to your hands. Give us, Lord, the heavenly understanding, Lord. Give us, Lord, the mind which was in Jesus. For I commit all our children, Lord, in your hands, Lord. And also those who are missing, Lord, I commit them also in your hands. Like all glory be to Jesus. Bless us specially in this moment as we commit ourselves to you. In your precious name, we pray and we say, amen.
Amen. So I'm going to say, look and live. Go to keynote.
You know keynote?
Amen. Amen. So today we are going back to Joseph, and I think we're going to finish this today, and next time we start with Moses. Yeah? So let us stand for the reading of the word. Can we just read it together? Let's go. And Joseph saw his brethren, and he knew them, but made himself strange unto them, and spake unto them, and he said unto them, Whence come ye? And they said, From the land of Canaan by food. And Joseph knew his brethren, but they knew not him. Amen. Lord, bless the name of your word. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. Amen. So, I want you to pay me your attention, because today I'm going to finish with Joseph. Okay? What is Joseph? You watch this here. So I was saying that I want you to pay me your attention, because I'm going to close today, yeah? Because next time when we'll be starting the faith of Moses, if you don't understand what I'm saying now, you will not understand the faith of Moses, because they are linked. Amen. When we started with Moses, it was about the children of Israel being slaves in the land of Egypt. Okay? And we said that we can't start there without teaching first how did they get in slavery. That the vision went back to Joseph. So Joseph, as you know the story, he was sold by his brethren and he went to the land of Egypt. But Joseph had faith to God. He knew that God had the control of everything. He knew that everything is taking place in my life is God, the one who's doing something. God wants to take me somewhere. And he said that God had his program. He said, he told David, Abraham, that your people will sojourn in the strange land. There will be slavery, there will be slavers for 400 years. And for God to fulfill what he said, he must do something to take them in that place. That the vision, it started with Joseph. And if you notice, after Abraham, the one who received the promise from God, there came another son after another son was born to Abraham, which was Isaac. And during Isaac's time, the promise wasn't fulfilled. You understand? So when God tells something, God has got his program. That's the reason we are talking about God's plan. Even for the redemption, God had a plan. You understand? The thing is today in the message, so many people, most of the people, they don't understand what is God's plan. Amen? Everything has got a plan. Even before to come here, we had a plan. We said that we are meeting here every Sunday. Everyone knows the plan.
start our Sunday school at 11 until we finish around 12. After 12, we're going to have a little break. Yeah. After a little break, we come back, we sing, we preach, we pray, and we're done. What is that? A plan. And God also had a plan. Going to the church is not enough. Amen. If you are going to the church without going and knowing God's plan, you are wasting your time. You must know what God is looking for, what God is planning to do. Where is God according to his plan now? That's the reason why Abraham said that if you don't want to get lost, just follow the types. And Abraham said that Joseph was the type of Jesus Christ. He said the perfect type of Jesus. If you understand things about Joseph, then you understand things about Jesus. You see that when Joseph was sold by his brethren, he went to the land of Egypt. He became the great man in the land of Egypt. He was the second personality in the land, next to the king. And Abraham said that it was like Jesus when he came, was the king as well. And you notice that in the prison, Joseph had two people, the baker and the butler. And Abraham said that it was like Jesus in on the cross. He was, when he was crucified, there was two people. One was thief, and one was saved. One died, and one was saved. Exactly the type of Joseph. Amen? So now, Joseph went to the land of Egypt. For Jacob, Joseph died. Because he has been told that your son Joseph has been eaten by the deadly animals and your son is no longer living. And Joseph went on the ground, on the dust, putting the dust upon his head, crying his son Joseph, because Joseph was the preferred son of Jacob. Why? Because Joseph's mother was Rachel, isn't it? Yes. Rachel was the choice of Jacob. When Jacob got married to Rachel, Laban, the father, said that in our custom, you can't get the little sister without, the little sister cannot get married without the big sister getting married first. If you want to get married to Rachel, you must get first Leah. You understand? But Leah wasn't Jacob's choice. His choice was Rachel. But he said, anyhow, because I love Rachel, I'll take Leah. And I'll walk another 7 years, I don't know. So he walked more years. It was a way to pay, to pay money to get his wife. It was, you must walk for a couple of years. So he worked like 7 or 12 years, something like that. When he completed his work, and then he said, okay, now you are allowed to get Rachel. So Jacob took Rachel and Leah. Leah was a big sister to Rachel. Amen. It's the Old Testament. But Joe, are you okay?
Yeah.
Good. Well, why are you not coming here? I want to see you. Come in front. No, here. Next to Joseph. I want you to feel okay, yeah? I want you to feel great. Yeah? So, and he took both sisters, two of them. But in Jacob's choice, it was Rachel. Amen? It was Rachel. That's the reason. And what happened? Rachel wasn't giving birth, but Leah was giving birth. And that one was hard for Joseph because his choice was Rachel. Until one day, Rachel gave birth to Joseph. He said, oh, finally, I've got the son of my choice. And Joseph was the little boy of all of them. You know how it is, you know, like birthday boy. Where's birthday boy? Where is he? Where's Gershom? Gershom? Yeah. Where are you? What are you doing there? This is not time to eat. Come. What?
Mom told me to call you.
You are eating. And then, you see, I was talking about the last boy in the family. Yeah, you see, Gershom is the last boy in the family by now. And it used to be but a prince, but unfortunately, you are not anymore. So the last boy in the family now is Isabel. Yeah, Isabel. So if you see parents, they love a little bit more the last boy, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Have you noticed that?
Yeah.
Yeah? Are you jealous about it?
Yeah,
princess. Yeah? Prince is jealous about Isabel. Yeah? Are you jealous? No. Do you like Isabel? Tell me the truth. Do you like Isabel? You do? Oh, praise God. I hope that you do. Because when Bonnet was born in the beginning, Benji was so jealous. Benji was like, this baby. She was so jealous. Do you know why? Because it's not because the parents love them more, but it's because they are small and they need more attention. That's the only reason. Do you understand? And sometimes the last born children, they take advantage on that. So now start doing things because I'm the loved one. No, we love you all the same. Do you understand? Yeah, birthday boy. Do you understand? Yeah? Yeah. So we love you all the same, but we are paying more attention to the small one because they're small, take care of them. But when you grow up, you are all the same. And Joseph was loved by his father. He was the best son of Jacob. But in this case, it was a little bit different because, first of all, because it took time for Rachel to give birth. Secondly, Joseph was the son of Rachel, which was the preferred wife of Jacob. Do you understand? So take all those things together. It made Jacob to love Joseph more. And this one brought jealousy in their family. All his brethren was angry about him. So, but remember, all that was God's plan. God was fulfilling his plan to take them into slavery. Do you understand? And to show his power. So when we get in Moses' faith, you understand a little bit more. Amen. So let us stay with Joseph. And Joseph has been sold by his brethren. He went to the land of Egypt. He became the great king. And in the same time, Jacob knew that my son is dead. He was my preferred son. Now he's dead. It's finished for me. So when they came to Jacob to tell him that Joseph's still living, for Jacob, Joseph was like, it was like the resurrection of Joseph. Amen. As Jesus. You see, the perfect type of Jesus. Now, just follow step by step, you understand how Jesus is meeting his brethren. So, Jesus' brethren is, brethren are, who's that? Jewish people. You understand? But when I say that God doesn't work with nations, Jewish and nation at the same time. So, he started first with Jewish people. When Jesus came in human flesh, he came to die. He told them that I came for the lost sheep of Israel. Mm-hmm. In,
his first coming. And but Abraham said that when he came, he was rejected by his brethren, and after being rejected, he came now to the nation. He went to the road of Damascus, the same Jesus, the pillar of fire, came to meet now Paul. He said, I am Jesus. Do you understand? And Paul went to meet Peter and all three disciples. Peter told Paul, said, you were sent to the Gentiles. So Peter was sent, was preaching to the Jewish people, but Paul was sent to the Gentiles. So Paul came, but when I'm preaching the seven church ages, Paul started the age of, the first age, what is that? Ephesus, church age. And then the Gentiles started. But now you notice that Jesus, after meeting the Gentiles, he must go back to meet his brethren. Amen? Where? Is Jesus going back to Israel again? No. According to the times, Joseph was in Egypt. And his brethren came from the land of Israel to meet Joseph in Egypt. Egypt is the nation. That's the reason the Bible says that as the sun rises from the east and west, and so shall be the coming of the Son of Man. Who's the Son of Man? Jesus. That's the reason we are saying Jesus is not about his body. Jesus is about the works he's going to do. The only way to recognize Jesus is about the work he's going to do. But what I'm saying that if you see a man here standing with his cup of nails at his hand, he said, don't believe him. Somebody can come like this with this robe, red robe, and his hair like this. He says, I'm Jesus. Tell him, get away. Amen. Don't let him to deceive you. It won't be Jesus. When Jesus comes, why Jesus was dressing himself like this? Because in that time, people used to dress like this. Do you understand? So if Jesus comes back today, he won't be like this anymore. Jesus, when he comes back, he will have a tie. And shoes like me. Do you understand? So the same Jesus, the pillar of fire, came back again. Amen. Doing the same works. And you see the people in the message of God upon them telling that we are waiting for Jesus Christ. What Jesus Christ we are talking about? Do you understand? Jesus is supposed to meet his brethren where? In this side, the nations. Amen. So the Bible says, and Joseph saw his brethren. Notice. And he knew them, but made himself what? Strange unto them. So Joseph knew them. So when Jesus saw Jewish people, he knew them. Because this man here, okay, he had the power to discern the thought of people. So when he was standing there, he can take, he was able, not him, but the Lord Jesus Christ, the pillar of fire in him, was doing the work. And Barbara said that if you want to understand that it's not me deserting the thought of the heart of the people, I'll turn my back for you to know that it's not me. And start telling people, such and such brother, you came from such and such place. You give even the address, everything. Even the postcode. Amen. I'll tell you, one day, Barabana traveled, I thought I told you about it, I'll tell you again, how Brother Sidney Jackson met Barabana. Do you know the story, you know? Can you tell me how? Yeah? You can't remember.
I didn't like explain.
You don't know how to explain? Brother Sidney Jackson met Barabana. Do you know how? But Barnum was living in America, isn't he? He had some meetings in South Africa. Don't switch it on, it's hot today. Oh, are you cold?
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. So Barnum went to South Africa. Barnum was in the car, yeah, with someone. Barnum was that person was driving Barabara, And Brother Sidney Jackson was standing on the bus station like this. And can you remember? And Brother Branham stopped the car. He got out of the car. He said, I am the person you saw in your dream. I'm the person you saw in your dream. Okay? So I'm William Branham. And Brother Sidney Jackson was like this. He didn't say anything. And Brother Branham went back in the car. He went. And after that, he stopped the car. He came back again. He said, I forgot to tell you something. In your dream, you saw me smoking. Brother Branham said, I was because I was backsliding. How Brother Branham did backslide? Do you think Brother Branham can backslide?
No.
God told him to go to Africa. But he went to India. Because his friend told him that, let's go to India. He said, God told me to go to Africa. Now you're telling me to go to India. I know that I'll get in trouble with God. But he went to India anyhow. And God was unhappy with him. He said, that the reason you saw me in your dream smoking a cigarette. God bless you. And Brother Sidney Jackson was there. How can you imagine someone having a dream in South Africa and someone coming from America without knowing that person, straight away is going to speak? And he met him at the bus station. He was passing in the car. How can you imagine that? Do you think, is it this man dream that? No, it was Jesus in him. So when you see all those things has been done again, that means Joseph or Jesus is here. But Abraham could know him, not him. Jesus in him could not recognize people, but those people didn't recognize who was standing there. So when his brethren came in front of Joseph, Joseph dressed himself like an Egyptian. The Bible says that, and spake roughly unto them. Amen. He wasn't angry to them. He was just making it up. Joseph knew that these are my brethren. But let me play a game with them. So then they thought that Joseph was serious. Do you understand? The Bible says, and he knew them, but made himself strange unto them. That's what Jesus is doing. So you never recognize Jesus until Jesus himself is going to reveal himself to you. You understand? That's the reason we say that no one can give the revelation to someone. Jesus himself has got the ability to make you to understand the message. Do you understand? That's what we call the revelation. One day someone told Brother Branham, oh, Brother Branham, I don't believe in the revelation. Brother Branham said, if you don't believe in the revelation, you don't believe in anything. Because it's all about the revelation. Amen. So this problem was here, it was to recognize the person who was standing in front of them. So for those people, they thought that the person, the one who was standing before them, they thought that he was just an Egyptian. Do you understand? Not knowing that it was their brother. Amen. So Barbara said that the court of God is the prophet. Do you understand? So if Jesus must come back, we come back as a prophet.
Amen.
Do you understand? Because a prophet is nothing else than God himself. So the prophet is just the court of God. Do you understand? Even Jesus was a prophet as well. And this body was the court of God. But the thing is, this one was virginally born because this body came to pay the price. Do you understand? So in his second coming, he doesn't have to come to be born virginally because the price has been paid. This body came just to claim his children back to himself. Amen. So the main reason of Jesus' second coming is just to claim his own. How? By the opening of the word. Because when we open the word, everyone will understand who he is. That's the only way God claims his own. Are you free? So we can't expect a little man coming, I don't know from where, someone like this, to come again and we call it the second coming. No. Why? What is he going to do? He doesn't have any job to do. But what I'm saying that if he comes again, so he must go again on the cross and die again. Are you feeling? Because the only reason of this body was to die on the cross. So there's no point to bring this body back again if it's not going to die anymore. Are you feeling? And he said that in that day I'll be in you. God will become his people. But before to become one with his people, he must come first as a prophet. Amen. Who is one? He's a prophet. So the same Jesus, the one who was in him, as I said last time, there was Jesus in Jesus. So this is Jesus, and this man here, his name also was Jesus. But the thing is, when this Jesus is changing the dwelling place, this Jesus is no longer living, but this Jesus is still living. Are you with me? This Jesus was with Moses, this Jesus was with Abraham, this Jesus was with Joseph, this Jesus was with Barabbas, and this Jesus is still here today. Now the reason Barabbas said that, the same Jesus was on the street of Galilee, still the same here, walking in Kentucky. So the thing is, we misunderstood who Jesus is. So the type of Joseph is really showing us who Jesus is. Listen, and spake roughly unto them, and he said unto them, whence come ye? And they said, from the land of Canaan to buy food. And Joseph knew his brethren, but they knew not him. So let's say that they were looking for Joseph. So they will be looking for Joseph, don't understand, when Joseph is standing there. Are you with me? So people will be looking for Jesus when Jesus is standing there. So why those people didn't recognize Joseph? Because he dressed himself like an Egyptian. Amen. And he was speaking the language of Egypt. Everything changed. His appearance changed. His language changed. The way of his dressing changed. Everything changed. But it was the same Joseph. If you take someone, the person inside of this world, it's still the same Joseph, the son of Jacob. Amen. I don't care how he dressed himself, but it's still the same Joseph. But the thing is, he didn't make up everything so no one could recognize him. But he was there. Are you with me? It's exactly the same as Jesus Christ today. Jesus is standing there. But he changed his coat. Do you understand? Who is going to recognize Jesus? He's the only one. Those one was in God's mind. Amen. And the Bible says, and Joseph remembered the dreams which he dreamed of them. Can you remember again? What was the dream? What was the dream? He saw the sheaves. The sheaves of wheat bowing. Yeah. Bound themselves in front of Joseph. You understand? So this one is over maybe 40 years. So now this one was the fulfillment of the dream he had. So Joseph understood that God had a plan. This is the time God is fulfilling his plan. That's the reason we are talking about the faith of Joseph. Nowhere you are going to see Joseph hating his brethren because of what they did to him. No. He knew that God had a plan. You know, when you know God's plan, you never accuse anybody. You must know that your life is in God's hand. Amen. No one can do anything bad to you until God permitted them to do it. You understand? So if God wants to take you somewhere, He's got something to do with you. When He's got something to do with you, He's going to take you maybe through sickness, through troubles, but God has got His plan. You understand what I'm saying, brother? As it was with Brother Jess, I said, God has got His plan with Brother Jess. I don't care what's going to take place. If it's God, it's a God's son, God still has control. And can you imagine now, Brother Jess is sitting there much better than what it was before. Mm-hmm. And answer. You too mad. I like him like this now. So every time when I see Brother Jess, I'm happy. God had a plan. Because he had his own experience with God. Very important. So don't see what is taking place, but see what God is doing. Are you with me? So Joseph was betrayed by his brother to become the second personality of Egypt. Can you remember? But by becoming the second personality of Egypt, also God was taking them in slavery. Up, down, up, down. Amen. And all of this, those one together, it was God's plan for the redemption. Are you with me? It was God's plan for the redemption, because that plan started in the book of Genesis with Adam and Eve. Joseph, Moses, everybody was fulfilling God's plan. And the very end of the plan of God was the bride of Christ. And the bride of Christ is us. So we are the fulfillment of all types. Mm-hmm. Abraham, Jacob, all of them, they are not more powerful than you and me. Do you know that we are more than Moses? Yes. Are you with me? Mm-hmm. But I want to say that people can say, oh, Moses was so powerful, he could open up the sea. But I want to say that do you know that you are more powerful than Moses? You are more than Abraham. But I want to say that why? Say, because what we are believing today, if you take Moses today to believe exactly what we are believing today, it's going to be hard for him. Mm. But I want to say that if I had a choice to choose where I would like to live, but I want to say that I will live in this age. Mm. He said, this one is the golden age. Amen. Can you remember someone like Joseph? A great man like Joseph, but you've got more faith than him. Someone like Moses, leading 4 million people on the wilderness, but you are more powerful than Moses. Someone like Samson, you could kill the lion, but the Bible says, but the Bible says that we are more than Samson, all of them. Because the Bible says that all of them was looking that day to the end. They really appreciate us. They say, oh, how can you live in such age? Why? Because in that time, you don't have television, you don't have internet, but now, Satan is killing more on social media. You understand? Satan is more dangerous than before. Before, if Satan wants to get you, he'll tell you, I'll stop you going to the church. If you go to church, he'll kill you. People say, okay, you can kill me. Because I go to church. It was much easier. But today, Satan can let you go to church. When you come to church, you get your mobile phone when the pastor is preaching there. Do you understand? You are killed already. But if you can stand against those things, then Moses will say, these people, they are special. Because God designed special people for this age. To believe what we are believing today. Are you with me? Mm-hmm. Praise be to God. So Joseph remembered his dreams. He said, this is the time. And what he was doing, he said, and said unto them, ye are spies. start accusing them that he was playing a game. It's not so. Are you with me? So for them, it was an Egyptian talking to them. Said, oh, come on, we get in trouble here. Say, you are spies to see the nakedness of the land. You are come here. So you come here as spies to make trouble in Egypt. So you'll be arrested. No. Please. They went in their knees like this. What was it? The fulfillment of Joseph's dreams. Yes. So if God tells something he's going to do, brothers and sisters, you must know that he's going to do it anyhow. Yes. I don't care how long it's going to take, but God is going to do it. So here, after more than 30 years, because Joseph went there for more than 30 years, 40 years, something like that, God had his plan. And that one was the plan. They said, oh, we are going to die now. It's finished for us. It's finished. And Joseph told them, so, where you come from? They said, we came from the land of Israel. Who's your father? Our father is Jacob. Amen? Remember, they are talking to their own brother. His brother knew them, but they knew him not. Okay? So, do you have another brother? He said, yes. But he's no longer living. He died. Follow me. So when they were thinking that their brother died, but the brother was standing in front of them, he's the one who was asking them questions. We had a brother, his name was Joseph, and he died. And until now, after more than 30 years, our dad still crying about Joseph. He said, okay, we'll fight. So what about his little sister? Is that Joseph had a little? Yeah, little brother, I mean. Yes, his name is Benjamin. Oh, but where is he? So now he's not here with us. So I would like to see him. So I'll give you food, go and bring your little brother here. I want to see him. So Joseph was taking his time. You understand? Jesus takes his time to reveal himself. Before to reveal himself, he takes time. And they went back to the land and said, oh God, we met a wonderful man. So kind to us, he gave us even food. We didn't pay anything. Wow! Oh, God is so wonderful. Amen. God is a provider. They didn't know that it was their own brother. But the man said that we have to take Benjamin. He said, what? He said, No. He said that we have to take Benjamin with us. He said, No. Not this Benjamin. Because his brother died. Until now, I'm still feeling the pain in my heart. Don't take Benjamin. He said, if we don't take Benjamin, there's no food anyway. If we don't eat, we're going to die. Because the only place where you can find food is in Egypt. Or, the types. He said, now, okay, take Benjamin with you, but make sure that you bring him back. Otherwise, you kill me. Say, oh, no, he doesn't. No, we take Benjamin back. Come on, Benjamin, let's go. Benjamin was the last born of the family, like birthday boy. Where is he? He said, disappear again. And then they took Benjamin. When Joseph saw Benjamin, it was the first time for Joseph to see his brother. Can you imagine? But Joseph said, I'm not going to cry. Amen. He took Benjamin. I'm looking for you. You come back here. So Joseph was about to cry and say, oh, my brother, it's my first time to meet you. Because when Joseph left, Benjamin wasn't there. He was born after him. His only brother, can you imagine? But didn't say anything. Amen. Joseph didn't say anything. And Joseph said, what am I going to do now? Okay, He took his cup, put hands there, suffering. Before the coach said, hey, listen. Before you go, I've lost something. Something is lost here. So I want to make sure that you didn't put in here. No, we didn't take anything. So no, let me check. That's fine, let me check. Joseph now start checking, and he found the cup. He said, what is this? All of you are thieves. So get them and put them in prison. And they start crying, no! We are sorry. He said, okay, if you don't want me to get you, I'll just keep your brother Benjamin. And Reuben said, please, if you want someone to stay here, please take me, not Benjamin. He said, why? Because our dad, after the death of our brother Joseph, if you take Benjamin, our dad is gonna die. Please don't do it. Take me. He said, why do you want to take your brother's place? He said, because of my dad. Please don't do it. And the Bible says that Joseph couldn't contain himself. He told all the Egyptians to get out. You understand? And Joseph started crying. He said, I am your brother. So what? Are you my brother? Are you our brother? Are you Joseph? He said, yes. When he said it, Joseph, can you imagine someone who betrayed you? No, you betrayed someone. And you found that person in that kind of position, the second personality of the land. Do you understand? The prime minister of the land. So you think that today is finished for us. We are dead. Do you understand? But Joseph said, don't worry. God done it for our purposes. Where is my father? Jacob. The Bible says that when Joseph was crying, all the people in the palace heard his voice. But God said, what is that? He said, before Jesus to reveal himself to his brethren, Jesus will take the church out of the city. But remember, those people heard Joseph. It means that they didn't go far. Do you understand? They were there somewhere. Okay? And then Joseph starts crying. After that, he said, I'm your brother Joseph. And I had two sons, Manasseh and Ephraim. So those two children of Joseph was half Jewish, half Egyptian. So he brought them all together. And they made one family. Can you remember? So you see it now, Egyptians and Israel making now one family. Do you understand? And Barabbas said that Joseph is the type of the type of Jesus. So when Jesus comes again, he will put everybody together. You understand? Where? In Egypt. Because the only place they could find food, it was in Egypt, not in Israel. So there's no point for Jesus to go there or Joseph to go there. They must come where Joseph was. And Jesus was here, discerning the thought of the heart of the people in this man here. So Israel had to come here. And Barabbas one day in prayer line, he saw a Jewish girl was coming there. Barabbas said that you are Jewish, not from Israel. This is the time for you to meet him. You understand? And Barabbas said that if just one Jewish people get the message, it's finished. All of them will get it at the same time. Do you understand? Jesus came in form of William Branham to meet his brother here. And this one finished the story of Joseph. Today, if Jesus came here, Jesus was speaking to them today. In which language? In English. And one day, in the prayer line, Brother Branham was praying for a little girl from Mexico. Brother Branham took the girl, he was praying in English. And after prayer, the girl told the person was translating, say, "Oh, I didn't know that he could speak perfectly Spanish like this." And the translator said, "But Abraham, did you speak in Spanish?" He said, "No, I spoke in English." The girl said, no, he was praying in Spanish. But Abraham said, "I understand. It's the promise of the Bible that when they speak, that everyone will hear them in their own language." Are you feeling? So today, the promise has been fulfilled. Let me read, but Abraham, go ahead. But I want to say, he's saying this in the revelation of Jesus Christ. He said, "Now, where will the Gentile church be while Jesus is making himself known to his brethren? Remember that the bride of Jesus, of Joseph, with the two children are in the palace. For Joseph had commanded, 'Let everyone leave me, put them all out from before me, before to meet his brethren.'" You must know that before God to meet you, you must take everybody out. But Abraham said that this one is individual matter. It's between you and God. He said that when Paul before, when he was on the top of his horse going to Damascus, when he met the pillar of fire, he said that all the soldiers was around him, they didn't see the light. The only one who saw the light was Paul. So this one, before to meet God, God will take everybody out. What means? It means that God will reveal himself only to you. That the reason every child of God must have the self-contact with God. Read the message and read your Bible. Are you feeling? Very important. Because when God meets someone, he's going to meet yourself, not you and someone else. That the reason, see, when we meet together, if everyone has got the connection of God, then we come for fellowship. Amen. He said, "So the Gentile bride was hidden in the palace of Joseph." So when Jesus come to meet his brethren, he's going to put the bride of his bride beside in the palace of Joseph. And that's the reason the people think that there's going to be a rapture. People will fly away to go I don't know where. Amen. But when I'm saying that the bride will go in the palace of Joseph, where will the Gentile church go in the rapture? He asked a question and he said, where? Into the palace. The thing is, what is the palace? The palace is not something far. You're still there because they heard the voice of Joseph cry when he was meeting his brother. Are you with me?
Yeah.
So the bride will hear the voice of Joseph crying when he's going to meet his brother. And today, this promise has been fulfilled already. It's a little bit hard for you guys, but I'm just telling you. The bride will be taken off the earth. That's the problem. The bride will be taken off the earth. Who's the bride? The bride is not your body. The bride is only your soul. She will be caught up before the great tribulation to meet her Lord in the air. But what's in the air is the space which has been designed for the redemption. You understand? This one is a little bit hard for you. But remember that Joseph met his brother in Egypt. So if Jewish people, they had to meet Jesus, they had to meet Jesus to the nation here in America, and they did it, do you understand? That the reason when you see the cloud coming down, but the Bible said that in the cloud, there was Jewish and Gentile church together, forming one church. Amen. God bless you. You have questions? Any questions? No?
Thank you.
Joseph was a type of Jesus. So that, Lord,